this week's Clubber, coming to you from Legends here in London. On this week's star-studded show, we'll be bringing you Who the Man, Word on the Street, Video Over, and a behind-the-scenes peek at this year's Music Awards. We'll also be bringing you performances from all our special guests, Warrior, Quo Vadis, and the lovely Duane Harden. I'm Samantha Mann, and it's time to get this party started. Tonight is somebody whose character is larger than life when he's behind the decks and on the airwaves. It's Mr. Graham Gore!
I'd dance with you!
There's always sunshine when I dance with you. Reminds me of summertime, baby. The way you make me smile, yeah, when I dance with you. I'm feeling good all the time, yeah, when I dance with you. Something about the way you move makes me feel good inside. I'm so glad that I found you, and I know our love will never die. As long as we can dance, there will always be our love. No matter what the circumstance, we can work it out between us. There's always sunshine. Woo! When I dance with you, reminds me of summertime, babe. When I dance with you, the way you make me smile. Feeling good all the time, yeah, when I dance with you.
You know what?
Every time that I'm with you, it's better than paradise. This kind of love I don't want to lose. You're the happiness in my life. And even though we had our share of love's ups and downs, imagine being anywhere in this world without you around. There's always sunshine. Woo! When I dance with you, reminds me of summertime, babe. When I dance with you, the way you make me smile, yeah. When I dance with you, I'm feeling good all the time. There's always sunshine. Woo!
How you feel, clubbers?
Whoa, baby. Something about the way that you move and everything that you do, the way it made me smile. It feels good all the time. Don't stop dancing, clubbers. Don't stop dancing, rapture. Don't stop dancing, no, no. Don't stop dancing. No, don't stop dancing.
Woo!
Don't stop dancing. There's always sunshine.
You know what, baby?
Every time I dance with you, no, 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 no. Reminds me of summertime.
Woo!
When I dance with you, the way you make me smile. Feeling good all the time, yeah, when I dance with you.
be seeing more of the delicious Duane later on after this week's video vote. Watch these three clips and let us know your favourite by either emailing us at clubber@prolificpicturesfsnet.co.uk or send a postcard to Clubber PO Box 4004 London W1A 6LU. It's as easy as that, and we'll see the winner in full next week. The legend of soul, Mr. Barry White, has re-released his top 10 hit, Let the Music Play. It's received a beach mix, there's just no stopping our buzzer. Yeah, right here, right here. Let the music play on. Move, kick and groove. I think I'm gonna be alright. Getting in the Way is taken from Jill Scott's debut album, Who is Jill Scott? Although she's not a newcomer to the scene, she's already established a name for herself writing and singing with several world-class acts. Sugar, honey, girl, fly, fly away. I've been a lady up till now, don't know how much more I can take. You Need Love Like I Do is taken from Tom Jones' multi-million selling album Reload. The track, which features Heather Small of M People, has been given a remix by Seventh District. It ain't no joke. My love life is just like a sinking boat. I can understand the person being with me. And this week's video vote winner is...
Said that she out the body and the music I play. She dead there and she ready. Clothes look tight and I hold her steady. To the bass line so heavy. Never see a woman with time is so tight. Never see a girl dance with all her might. She a boom up like dynamite. Cause everything look right.
No one could ever accuse us of not being transatlantic on this show. We've flown him all the way from the US of A. It's Duane Harden. Me glitter all over you now. I'm sorry.
It's alright.
You at the half be like, where have you been tonight?
I know.
For people at home that are wondering who you are, I mean, you were the vocalist on the major track, weren't you? I'm Van Helden's been born here.
Yes.
You don't know me.
You don't know
Has
me.
That blown you into mega stardom now?
I'm
Are we lucky
there.
To have you here?
I'm on flight. Yeah.
And we've just heard Sunshine as well. That's your latest track.
That's my latest.
Yeah. One. Tell us about that. Where did the idea come from?
I was out, you know, in a club in New York City, and I was dancing with my friend, and the lyrics just popped in my head, you know, Sunshine, when I dance with you, she was just making me feel good, and I started writing a song about it.
Isn't
but
it
I'm single and available, and, you know, I'm looking, so.
Don't say that. God, you've been mobbed, honestly, all the girls in the audience. You're the face of Tommy Hilfiger as well, aren't you?
Well, I'm doing that. They're sponsoring me. Always got to give props up to Tommy Hilfiger. You know, they approach me and they sponsor my wardrobe, and next year, I'm going to be looking to expand that role. So
excellent. Now, you threw the lucky dice there, really, didn't you?
Yeah.
Multi-skilled.
I've been blessed. So.
Definitely. Is there anybody you'd like to collaborate with?
Funny you mention that. I got a call from BMG.
Right.
And they asked me to do a duet with Gloria Gaynor.
Excellent.
And it turns out that I'm working on her whole comeback album. So hopefully that, you know, that'll pan out to something great. And I was like, wow, Gloria Gaynor. Oh, my God. You know, she's an icon in dance music. So that's going on, and a couple other things, but we won't talk about it.
You know, are you working on a new track, or are you just concentrating on Sunshine at the moment?
Always trying to look for something new, you know? Yeah. In fact, anybody out there watching, if you write songs or you produce and you think it's something for Duane Harden, look me up in Yahoo, you know, go to my website, send me your material, and I'll get back to you. But I'm always looking for great tracks, you know, great songs.
Do you like it?
The UK is the bomb. You know,
yeah.
I love
what
New
about,
York.
What about the ladies?
Oh. Hey, you can't compete. You can't
compete. Looking around. You got your eyes on all the girls.
You can't compete. You know, I love New York. Don't get me wrong. You know, New York is cool, but no one parties like the UK. And I've never seen a group of people that can party and go to work like nothing. Like, they will wake up and go to work. Like, as you guys say, piss, whatever. Like, you go out and get pissed. And they will go to work, and I'm just like, you know, in New York, everybody's like, oh, I'm sick, I'm not coming in today, you know, type thing. But people,
we are hardcore. Which is your favorite club in the UK?
Wow, there's so many. No, that's hard to say. But one of my favorites is one of these commercial clubs from, like, this corporation. Rankles or First Ledge or something like that, and it's an icon place. You know, they have food in there, you know, like, you can go and eat, and I'm like, yo, what's up, what's the deal? You know, I'm like, I'm surprised they don't have a laundromat. It's so much, you know, so much stuff in this club. And I just, you know, I thought it was the bomb, like 5,000 people, just like, yo, in the middle of nowhere, I can't believe it.
Excellent, brilliant,
yeah, so brilliant. I love
the UK. How much time do you spend here?
I'm surprised I don't move here.
Yeah,
I'm here think so we should, much.
Do you think you should move here, so everyone?
Yeah!
I think you should move here. It'd be great. It'd be good. You're big fans in the UK.
I'm over here a lot, so. And
brilliant.
I love it, you know. The
brilliant.
People give me much respect, and thank you very much.
So we'll be seeing you later, if you don't know me.
Yes.
And it's time for a short break now, but stay tuned, because after the break, we've got performances from Warrior, Quo Vadis, and Duane. So don't go away. With me, Samantha Mann. It's now time for me to hand you over to the sexy, gorgeously, satisfyingly tantalizing Mr. Graham Gold. I'm coming, Gray.
And a big round of applause, please, for the tantalizing trio, Quo Vadis with Sonic Boom.
Open your mind.
Spiritual thing, a body thing, and a soul thing. Hi, I'm Nadia, and this week on Word on the Street, we're out to terrorize the public about their views on music. What are you listening to?
I'm listening to a tune by a guy called Bob James.
Where are you from?
Greece?
Tangled in Manchester.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you Mancunian?
Yeah.
Let's have it! Are you English?
I am.
Oh, that's amazing. We found an English person in England. Do you listen to house music?
I do.
Excuse me? No. I thought not. Do you listen to house music?
Yes, I do.
Favourite house DJ being?
Yeah.
I listen to a bit of house now and then.
Okay, so who's your favourite house DJ?
I'd say, probably at the moment, I'd say Timo Mas.
Tiesto?
Mm. You define a caner.
I don't know what a caner is.
Well, I'd say it's an idiot, a stupid bloke.
Tell the viewers at home about your mate Tim.
He's a nutter.
Are you a caner?
Yeah. I am.
Does that explain the reason why you're also monosyllabic on a Monday morning?
No.
Do caners earn respect?
You're a bad role model for the kids.
You know, whenever I'm out and about, I've got my Waterman on and I'm just bopping like this.
Yeah. Most hated house track?
Coochie.
Do you remember the old house tunes? Things like Voodoo Ray by a guy called Gerald.
Voodoo Ray, Bizarre Ring, that kind of stuff.
Bizarre Ring, they're from my hometown.
For an angel, actually.
Sing it back, bring it back, sing it back, bring it back to me.
You don't even know me. You say that I'm not living right. You don't understand me. So why do you judge my life?
Are you too cool to be singing in the street, really?
Of course.
Am I scaring you? Because you keep running away. You're like, bye!
We've just seen them perform. Let's have a very warm welcome for Andy, Julian and Fionn, aka Quo Vadis.
Just heard
Sonic Boom. Tell us about that. How did you get together?
Well, we've basically been, you know, me and Julian have been working together for
4 years.
5, 6 years.
You've known each other since you were
17 years old, yeah.
Like years ago. And, you know, we used to be at Cross Tracks, had some success there with Perpetual Motion, and then decided, you know, it's time for us to all get together and do a track, so.
Just remixed Sonic's track?
Yeah.
Which track was that?
It's Put a Spell on You. It's okay. the new one that's due out, I think, in about a month's time or so.
Any good?
Yeah, it was our first ever release.
Yeah.
And they've re-released it.
You done a good job?
Yeah.
I think so.
I hope so.
We hope so, anyway.
I like to be blunt. And Fionn, you was Colour System Inc. before you joined up with these guys. So tell us what you did before.
Generally, like one of the few British producers, me and Paul Harris, to do like American Deep House Morales type stuff. Done about 50 major remixes from Louise, Boyzone, if I dare say, Roachford. It's like too many to mention. Like real classy American house. Like it's very hard to do that stuff over here because the scene is so regimented with different types of music. So that's what we stuck to, and we got the work out of it doing like that. It's like well respected for doing it. That's why I'd like to get back into doing a bit more of that, as well as this pumping our stuff, which is good as well.
And of course, Andy, you're one half of the Clockwork Orange boys.
Yeah.
And also you're DJing. How's that going?
Yeah, DJing's going well. I've just been actually taken on to Duty Free Management, which is Tall Paul's sort of like record label and stuff like that. So they're going to be promoting me from next year. So it's, you know, it's all looking like it's going to fall into place, touch wood.
Excellent. And what about the future for you guys?
Carry on working.
Yeah.
Just be moving away.
Hopefully getting a chance for a couple of weeks, everyone goes out and buys it.
Now you're going to kill me now because you're going, don't stitch me up, Sam, because last time we spoke I stitched you up, I'm really sorry. But I heard that you use one of these electronic... electronic swimming pads.
He was just telling me about.
You know, I desperately need to do something.
it did work, but it don't.
Did it work?
Sort of. Depends how much food you eat.
What did you do? Did you get in bed
case,
and put it
quite
on?
A lot, so I don't really know.
No, you just sit there and watch. It's too cold because you have to put wet pads on, so you sit there and you're like, fucking start again, I just swore then.
No, you
sit there and you're like, put it out of the
pot,
it's like someone sort of smashing your stomach with a cricket bat or something like that. Like.
Well, thank you very much for coming on the show. Are you going to stick around, have a drink, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, Graham, it's now time for a musical interlude. Are you there?
One of the top tunes in Ibiza this summer. A big shout out for the Warrior with Warrior.
Warrior.
big and it's ready to explode. It'll be right here with me, Samantha Mann. Now, moving on rather swiftly, it's time to take a sneak peek behind the scenes at this year's Music Magazine Awards with the ever so nosy Nadia.
We're here at the Music Awards 2000, where, of course, there's lots of glitz, glamour, shaking of the booty, and, of course, attitude with me, Nadia. Let's see what's going on backstage. John Digweed, congratulations. Let's see your award. It's the first one I've seen this evening.
Thank you. It's not just me, it's Sasha as well.
Oh, is it Sasha as well? Yeah. I take it he's not here. He doesn't like these big PR events, does he? Norman Cook, can I see your award, please?
Yes. I'm really disappointed it wasn't a smiley, because I'm an international smiley collector. And I do like my smileys. Got one here.
You are? Let's see your tattoo. Oh, we're here with the best Ibiza single of the year, is that right?
Ask him. I'm holding the other one.
Let's have a look at it. Yes. Oh, News of the World, yeah. Best single. I thought it was an Ibiza single. Oh, and another one.
We got two. One.
Hi. Mark Spoon.
Hi.
What have you won?
Kano of the Year.
Kano of the Year. And there's a lot of viewers who like that title. Danny Tenaglia.
Hello.
What a privilege.
What an honor.
What can I say? What have you done to deserve this?
I just said I'm able to be an asshole like Eminem.
Well, I'm here with Tim Westwood. He's very much taller than me, so you probably can't hear me. Hello.
What's up, baby?
How you doing?
Yo, that light is crazy bright. That light is crazy bright.
Well, I'm here with Wookie. You've just actually done a PA on stage. How was it?
It was excellent, actually. All went to plan.
Well, I'm here with the very sexy Eric Murillo, and you know you're sexy, don't you, honey? What award have you just won?
Well, we just received Best New Artist.
Sarah, how's it going?
Yeah, wicked, thank you. I've finished now, so it's really good.
Was it a good laugh?
It was, actually. Pete Tonga is a diamond geezer. And no, it went really well. It was all right.
How tall are you? You're actually giving me a neck ache.
Oh, for real? Why? What happened?
You're about 6'8".
We can make it work, baby. This could work. This could work.
Yeah, in bed, it doesn't matter, does it, what size you are? You're incredibly tall. I think you should play basketball. If it's a boy or a girl, can I ask you?
Yes.
Where is it?
It's a boy.
It's a boy. And have you named it?
Yeah.
Him, sorry. Have you named him?
Yeah, Woody. I won Best Independent Label 2 years in a row. How about
that? Oh, very good. How are you handling your newfound fame?
He just gets called Wookie and he's laying on. Yeah, it's very confusing. People tap you, Wookie!
Those awards, man, it's love, man. It's a good feeling, man. A lot of people showing support and love. I love, you know, awards is good, man. These things are nice just to get together.
Give us your best Cockney accent, Eric.
What? Let's have it, mate. You know what I mean? Fucking
wicked.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Rapture TV with a crazy bright light.
Well, I have to say, I'm a bit celebbed out here at the Music Awards. What a great night. It's time for me to hit the dance floor with all those lovely, lovely shakers and groovers. But for now, it's back to the studio to you, Sam, for rather an easy life, I suspect.
Easy life, I don't know. Right, we've just seen them perform. Please give a warm welcome for Warrior! Now, Michael, you've been in the industry for a while, but you've been sort of behind the scenes, haven't you?
Yeah, I used to sort of not work with Matt Derry, but I was sort of like, I used to be in a studio just to check out how he'd done all the tricks of the trade sort of thing, because I've been classically trained. My dad taught me the piano and stuff like that, and I wanted to get into the music industry, but it was through Matt really that I sort of learned how to do things.
That's Matt Derry from Mashup, isn't
Matt
it?
Matt Derry, yeah. That's one, yeah.
Okay, now we've just heard the tune, Warrior. Where did the tune come from? Where did the idea come from?
It's both of us, really. Michael gave me some music to take away, and he said, can you write something this music, anything around sort of angels or kind of thing. And originally I came up with another vocal, another lyric, and we spent about 4 or 5 hours recording this other thing, which we thought was okay, but probably not, you know, probably not dynamic enough really. And then before I was leaving the studio, I said, oh, take this down. I said, I've got this little hook come up in my head the other day, so I had one foot out the door, and it was literally the first take, so.
Brilliant.
You know, it was. It happens naturally, you know.
And this is your debut single, though, isn't it?
For me, yeah. I've sang lots of different stuff in the past, you know, mainly sort of a live sort of blues bands. Okay. I've done trip hop, that sort of. But this is a debut for me. Yeah.
And are you working on anything else at the moment?
We are working on a follow up. Yeah, we've got a few ideas. We don't know which one we like the best, do we?
Yeah, we've got a few ideas, but it's gonna be hard to top that one. Do you know what I mean?
Cause yeah,
it's
definitely.
Embraced by so many people, but. We've got a few ideas, so we're pretty confident.
Because I mean, that tune is everywhere. I mean, all the way through the Olympics, I kept hearing it as Sam Bez.
Audley Harrison's back.
Yeah, people phoning me up saying, you know your tune's on the Olympics. I was going, no, it's probably something else that sounds like it. And I was about four or five people from it, I thought.
How does that make you feel, though?
Good. It was really good because it's funny because we were travelling up to Cumbria, which was, you know, our first gig for Warrior. And, you know, people phone you up when you're sort of entering the M1, you're like, what's going on? Yeah, it's good. Good timing.
I must say, this outfit's great. It looks
painful.
Can I
sit down in it? I mean, this is actually for my PA. I've never tried to sit down before. Here I am, first time I sat down in front of all these people.
You try to sit down, you're going, you will sit down here now. We're going to make you sit down. You will be comfortable.
It's very boring.
That's great. Yeah. Okay, so what about the future?
Future's going to be, well, we're trying to work on a follow-up, that's the first thing, and then, don't know, we'll try for another one, maybe an hour, we never know, you know what I mean? But
just
we're trying
to
get...
Take everything as it comes, really, you know?
Yeah, take it as it comes. We're trying to get a follow-up probably by around Christmas, New Year sort of time.
Right.
So, I mean, we'll just see what happens after that.
Excellent. Well, if it's as successful as this one, then I'm sure you'll be very big. Yeah. It's one of those tunes that I'm just stuck in
it's
my
contagious.
Head all day, and I'm walking around, and then I bumped into you, and I'm like, I'm singing it, and going, I can't sing it in front of you.
Okay.
I've got the worst voice. I'm just going off on one. I'm going, la, la, la. You go,
I'm glad you like it.
You like the tune. Thank you very much for coming in.
Thank you for having us.
And hopefully we'll see you again, but good luck.
Thank you very much indeed.
Now it's time for a quick reminder of this week's video vote. Take a look at these three clips and tell us your favourite by either emailing us at clubber@prolificpicturesfsnet.co.uk or sending a postcard to Clubber PO Box 4004 London W18 6LU, and you'll see the winning video in full next week. Okay, we've seen him once before tonight, but before you make your decision, it's now over to our Graham with a quick reminder.
We do indeed have a treat for you. This tune has packed more dance floors than I care to remember. It is, of course, Duane Harden with You Don't Know Me!
What's up, Clubber? That's what I'm talking about. I want everybody up in there partying with me. And you at home, you better get up and party too.
You don't even know me. You say
everything I try to do. You haven't worn clubs, you haven't worn in my shoes. But you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna move on. It's my life, it's my life. Whose life is it? It's my life, it's my life. It's my life, it's my life.
A little clue, he's not so squeaky clean. Reveal all after the break. Welcome back. Now you've had a few minutes to think about it. Do you know who it is? Let's find out.
Yes, folks, you've been watching HP cleaning up his act on Clubber.
He's more like Caner of the Year than Cleaner of the Year, I don't know. We'll be seeing him next week anyway. Moving on, it's time to invite my last guest to the couch, the one and only, it's Mr. Judge Jules! You're going to do our video diary for us, aren't you? You're going to start filming a diary for us. So what have you got lined up? Where are you going to take the camera?
I don't know yet. It's just a question of being, try not to be too sort of predictable and not taking the camera out to too many clubs, because I think in general we've seen enough of what DJs do in clubs. Me on a Sunday with sort of bags under the eyes, really bad tempered, having had a late night the night before, a bit of a sort of a snapshot of Jules' domestic bliss or lack of.
Now, Amanda, is she working on another track at the moment?
She's just finished it. She finished the vocal element bit about a couple of weeks ago. I've just finished the music with Dan Tate. It's called Can't Keep Me Silent. And I think that sums me up really.
Brilliant. Because, I mean, her last track, It's My Turn, was fabulous. Did everybody enjoy that track?
Yeah.
It's My Turn. Brilliant track. We thought there was this one talent in the Jules family, but obviously there's two, and maybe there's a third.
I have actually made a record with him, but I don't think I'll ever put it out, because it's just a little bit...
I heard that. Yeah, was he laughing, or...?
Yeah, it's called The Laugh, and I made it, and I've been playing it for about the last 6 months, but I can't really sort of bring myself to release it, because it's not like he's got any choice in the matter, and it's a bit sort of...
Exploitation.
Well, not necessarily exploitation, but it's a bit sort of sick, really, isn't it, putting your child's record out. I don't want to be sort of... seen
pushy
as like,
dad.
Combination of kind of pushy dad meets posh and Becks.
So what are you working on at the moment?
Well, having sort of fairly recently finished our first summer of actually running a club in Ibiza, I popped off to Australia and I've sort of come back and I'm now working fairly hard in the studio. We're just about to start work on the Highgate album. We've had two sort of successful singles. We're going to put a third single out in January. The aim, if we can get it completed in time, is to do the album for sort of March or thereabouts, which would be nice, because when you're a DJ you make loads and loads of mix albums where you're sort of showcasing what you do sort of on the decks, but it's a wholly different and more challenging experience, if you like, to actually make an album that isn't just loads of dance records, is an album that stands the test of time, that is hills and valleys, mountains and troughs, you know, you've heard all the cliches, but ultimately we want to make something that is meaningful as a DJ-made thing. And one of the really difficult challenges facing anybody that makes dance records is making an album, an artist album that sells. I mean, the last couple of years have seen dance music absolutely conquer the singles charts and, of course, the compilation charts as well.
Definitely.
But there's been very, very few acts to break through at artist album level. Really, you could name them sort of on the fingers of one hand. In the past sort of 3 or 4 years, you've only really had sort of Basement Jacks, the Chemical Brothers, Daft Punk, a handful of other people. And I'm not sort of comparing myself with them because probably the style that they're producing in is different, but that's the ultimate challenge,
right,
is to do something that does sit highly racked in Woolworths and get bought by all people,
exactly,
as a truly,
yeah,
timeless album.
Excellent. You mentioned Ibiza and you had Judgment Sunday at Eden,
right,
didn't you, this year? How did that go?
Really good. We did a full summer,
yeah,
so we were really pleased.
What was your summer anthem?
I'd have to be quite sort of predictable now it's done huge things and say Zombie Nation, you know.
Right.
I mean,
mm-hmm,
it's all very well to say, you know, it's crossed over and you've got little kids in the street singing it, but I was playing it 6 months ago and it,
yeah,
was very clear from day one that it was going to be a huge record. I think kind of a defining feature of some of the biggest hit dance records are those that are played by a real cross-section of dance DJs, not necessarily just played by the sort of banging house DJs or the techno DJs or maybe the more sort of breakbeat orientated. Where a record really crosses the board and really appeals to the imagination of DJs from a variety of genres, you know you're going for something huge, and that was,
yeah,
probably the best example of that this year. There have been other good examples over recent years. I won't give you my historical rundown, I'll get too boring.
Well, I'm looking forward to the video diary.
Good.
I'm sure it's going to be great. So thank you very much for coming and seeing
My
us.
My pleasure.
And a big,
yo,
clap and a big yo, yo, yo for Judge Jules. He's not in the studio of Radio 1, he's come to our studio. Well, once again, we've run out of time. There's just time for me to thank all our special guests, mwah, all the audience, mwah, and of course, you lot at home, mwah. But as Arnie once said, I'll be back with next week's show when we'll have
Alex P,
TJ Cases and Cat Blue,
Love Connection,
Dynamite and
Christine Blonde. How on earth are you going to fit it all in?
I don't know, I'm sure we'll manage it somehow. See you next week.
See ya. Yeah!